Genesis 6:4 tells us that fallen angels came to the earth in ancient times, had relations with women, and created giants. And there's evidence of this all throughout Earth's ancient past. These two Sumerian scrolls really sum up all the evidence that I'm going to cover in this video that we see in cultures all around the world. In this scroll, we see one of the figures holding a handbag, as you will see is a common thread in cultures around the world. On this scroll here, we have a figure sitting down, the same height as the figure standing up, clearly what would be represented as a giant. As well here, we have a sun with heavenly bodies, the exact number of planets or heavenly bodies that we have in our system, something that the Sumerians definitely did not know 4,500 years ago. The Sumerians also taught that the gods, the Anunnaki, came from the sky and created humans. Now, most of the cultures of the world had no contact with each other until fairly recently in history, like hundreds of years, in the past hundreds of years. So the fact that all of these things that I'm about to show you were going on in cultures around the world at the exact same time proves that the fallen angels came to the earth and were mingling with humankind all around the earth. First, we'll look at the handbag. As I showed you in the Sumerian cylinder, they had the figure holding the handbag there. So from Sumer all the way over to the Americas, we have civilizations in Mayan cultures with figures holding the same handbag. Similar looking bags are found in Indonesia, as well as some of the gods in Egypt holding the Ankh, very similar to the other gods holding the handbags. So what else do we see in Egypt? Well, of course, we see the Great Pyramids of Giza. A strange fact about the pyramids is that in all the hieroglyphs and all the writings of ancient Egypt, which there's so much in comparison to many of the other ancient cultures, there's not a single hieroglyph or writing or picture of the pyramids or how they built them. But strangely enough, whether Egyptian, Mesopotamian, or Mayan, these cultures all around the world, no contact with each other, were all building pyramids at the same time as well. Of course, we have the Great Pyramids of Giza, we have the Pyramid of the Sun, Teotihuacan, Mexico, the Nubian Pyramids in Sudan, the Ziggurat of Ur in Iraq, Mayan Pyramids in Guatemala, and even the Pyramid of Cestius in Rome, Italy, built in 12 BC. So how were these massive structures built by people who weren't in contact with each other? Well, by the fallen angels of Genesis 6:4 and their offspring, the giants, who were in the earth before and after the flood, and we know this through many other Bible verses. One is 2 Samuel 21:20. It says, "Yet again there was war at Gath, where there was a man of great stature, who had 6 fingers on each hand and 6 toes on each foot, 24 in number, and he also was born to the giant," or Rapha, another name for giants. This is one of the greatest proof of the fingerprints of the fallen angels in the earth, is just the massive structures that were built in the ancient past, things that we can't even do today, but somehow they did with ropes and just lots of people. Absolute impossibility. And one of these main structures to point out, just mind-boggling, is the Trilithon at Baalbek in Lebanon. And these stones, these massive stones used as the foundation, weigh around 900 tons. I mean, the cranes today would have trouble moving these stones even today, but they were somehow lifted and perfectly placed on top of another foundation of stones that weigh around 400 tons. Absolute impossibility with manpower and ropes. The same thing we see with the massive stones in places like Sacsayhuaman in Peru, massive stones, laser cut precision. Again, something that we still don't understand how they did today. Extremely hard to imagine just large numbers of people with ropes and copper tools somehow managed to do this, especially when these laser cut precision stones have no chisel marks on them. Cusco, Peru has the exact same type of lined up stones. We also have a Lante Tombo, another just megalithic site. We have no idea how they moved these massive stones from one place all the way up to the mountain. Numbers 13:33 says, "And there we saw the giants, the descendants of Anak came from the giants, and we were like grasshoppers in our own sight, and so we were in their sight." Mind you again, this is all after the flood. So just like on the Sumerian cylinder scroll, we have the figures holding strange handbags. We also have the massive giant figure sitting in the chair, twice the size of the other figure standing up. And this is something we see in cultures around the world, again, in no contact with each other. In Greek mythology, there were giants that battled with the Olympian gods called Gigantomachy. In Norse mythology, there were giants that were in conflict with the gods and they were created by many marriages. Native American mythology has giants all throughout it: Navajo, Comanches, Choctaw in present-day Tennessee, the Manta people of Peru, and the Paiutes of Nevada had passed down stories describing a warlike race of white giants who were eventually wiped out. Interestingly enough, some of the stories say that they were destroyed by the gods because they were disgusted with their sexual habits, which we know from Genesis 6:4 and the Book of Giants say that they were mating with women and even animals, creating hybrid offspring. So it makes sense that this story, it stretches on from even the Bible and the extra biblical texts, even to Native American mythology. Hindu mythology has a race of giants known as the Daitas. Jain mythology has time divided into cosmological cycles in which the lifespan and height of people changed, and that at one time it was giant people walking on the earth. Celtic mythology states that the world was created by giants. And Armenian mythology says that Hak was the most famous of the Armenian giants. He was known for finding the Armenian state and contributed to the construction of the Tower of Babel. Before I get into all the different star god evidence of these different cultures, why is this important and what does it mean? All of these things either happened because aliens came to Earth, helping them build megalithic sites, teaching them this knowledge, holding weird things in their hands while they did it, so these cultures were all painting them in the same way, or fallen angels came to Earth and did the same exact thing. It's either aliens or fallen angels. Those are the only explanations, with so many cultures with no contact with each other doing the exact same things. And how can we know that the aliens are an evil spiritual phenomenon? Well, if you go to alienresistance.org, a website that sadly doesn't look like it's been updated like at all in the past few years, but there is still a pretty large number of testimonies on here of people who have called on the name of Jesus during their alien abduction and these entities flee. So these same star gods, these same gods from the past, these extraterrestrials from other planets, from Nibiru, these things are coming into people's rooms, harassing people, taking them on ships. But then when people decide to call on Jesus during these experiences, they stop. So this proves that it's a spiritual phenomenon, absolutely 100%. The same way when, sadly, in many cases, if say you were being grabbed by a group of people and taken into a car and you call on Jesus, not saying that it's impossible for it to stop, but people have free will, the same way that other intellectual beings would have free will as well. But for some reason, these entities, they're of a fallen nature. They are 100% under the authority of the spiritual realm. And so when you call on Jesus to these beings, they flee, proving in my eyes that these same entities that came, these ancient astronauts that came in the past to build the ancient structures of Earth and to teach these different things, really weren't extraterrestrial. They were how they were cast out of heaven and sent to Earth, and they corrupted mankind. They came before the flood and after that, like told to us in Genesis 6, and they very well will be coming again in the last days. Many of these different ancient cultures taught that these entities came from the sky, these star gods, as they really refer to them. In South America, there's a belief that the star woman who comes from the sky taught people about agriculture and then returned back to the sky. Many indigenous people in both North and South America believe that people are divided into two different types of people, sky people and earth people, in many cases, and it's believed that the ancestors of the sky people came from the stars. The humans of Arizona and California say that their ancestors came from the Pleiades system. In Polynesia, specific ancestors of existing families are alleged to have gone back and forth between the land of the sky people, earth, and the underworld. The Dogon are an ethnic group of indigenous people from the central plateau region of Mali in West Africa. They believe that fish-like men came from the star Sirius and taught them useful skills. Many of the Maya people believe and taught that the home of their ancestors is the Pleiades star system. And in Egypt, Sirius is associated with Osiris, Isis, Horus, Hathor, Anubis, and Thoth. So again, those are our two options. We have alien extraterrestrials or fallen angels. And so when these same alien creatures are going into people's houses, these same beings, these fish-like men that came and taught people things in all of Earth's ancient past. So when these people go into people's rooms these days and these people call on Jesus and they flee, makes it sure seem like they're tied to the fallen angel connection and just the fallen world of some sort or another. The Bible really points us to this truth in many different ways, and a few of these verses are Ephesians 6:12, which says, "We do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in heavenly places." Ephesians 2:2 tells us, "In which you once walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, which is the spirit who is now at work in the sons of disobedience." That's a title given to Satan. So one of Satan's titles is the prince of the power of the air, the same thing where these fish-like godmen from the stars came, disappear and reappear in our skies now, and are even harassing United States military jets as we speak. But again, these same entities, how do we know they're of a fallen nature? Well, we can look at Luke 10:17. What does that say? "And the 72 returned with joy and said, 'Lord, even the demons are subject to us in your name.'" So the same exact way that the 72 people following Jesus returned and they came back from casting out demons using Jesus' name, the same way that people nowadays, when they're being harassed and taken in UFO abductions, call on the name of Jesus and these things flee, proves they're of a fallen nature. And it proves that the fingerprints of the fallen angels are all throughout Earth's history and Earth's past. These megalithic sites, these same similarities in ancient art, all these different things, the star gods connection, these are of a fallen nature. And that's how we know, because these same entities, the only other explanation would be extraterrestrial. And people encounter these things still today. But when they do, and people call in the name of Jesus, they flee, just like a demonic force of spiritual wickedness would have to, just like told to us in these verses that I just mentioned. This is just a small list, but a few things that I find some of the most interesting when looking at Earth's ancient past. And again, this is important to know because spiritual wickedness, as it increases in the Earth, well, just like the 72 who returned with joy in Luke 10:17, they had power over this evil in Jesus' name. Again, I'd be curious to hear anything in the comments below of what you think about fallen angels in Earth's ancient past and the proofs and the connections from different cultures. Let me know what you think. Thanks for watching, and God bless.
But I can stand here and say that my husband, my daughter, and my son have not had any more experiences since I became a believer and gave it to him.